Hello students, good morning. By the way, I am your teacher for today, Teacher Leomar. So before we start our lesson, may I call all to please stand for our short prayer. Miss Unida, can you please lead the prayer? Okay, so in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good morning, everyone. How's your day? Excited? Good? Great? Oh, I'm glad to hear all of that. So now, please ready and prepare papers and pens. And let's have a wonderful day of addition of rational algebraic expression. Now, let's have a review. In our previous discussion, we discussed about addition of rational algebraic expression, right? So, I have a question. What have you learned about rational algebraic expression? Anyone? Oh, Mr. Ferrero. What have you learned about rational algebraic expression? What? Oh, that is correct. Very good. So, it is a fraction whose addition or numerator and denominator are polynomials. Very good. That is correct. So, a rational expression, it is a simply a quotient of two polynomials. Or in other words, it is a fraction whose numerator and denominator are polynomials. So, let's proceed to the second one. So, why or what is addition of rational algebraic expression? Anyone here? Oh, Miss Asa. What's your answer? What is the addition of rational algebraic expression? Oh, yes. Oh, that's good. Very good. That is correct. So, add or subtract the numerator and write the result over the common denominator. That is correct. Very good. Okay. So, rational expression is a ratio of two polynomials. To add or subtract two rational expressions with the same denominator, we simply add or subtract the numerators and write the result over the common denominators. When denominators are not the same, we must manipulate them so that they become the same. So the last one, why it is important the concept of adding rational algebraic expression. So, anyone? So, anyone answer this question? Why it is important to learn the concept of adding or adding the rational algebraic expression? So, no one can answer this question?
Yes.
Okay, so please listen carefully to know how or why it is important to learn the concept of adding rational algebraic expression. Okay, so rational equation can be used to solve a variety of problems that involve rates, times, and work. So using rational expression and equation can be used to answer question about how to combine workers or machines to complete a job on a schedule. So now we're going to find LCM. So anyone who can find the LCM of 4 and 6? So anyone? Oh, Mr. Kalamba, what is your answer? 12? Oh, that is correct. Very good. So how to find, first, how to find the LCM? So to find the LCM, list the multiples of each number until at least one of the multiples appear on all list. And the second one, find the smallest number that is all of the list. And the last one, this number is the LCM. So from the above given multiples of 4 and 6, it is the multiple 12. This is the smallest common multiple. Therefore, the LCM of 4 and 6 is 12. So now, let's have an activity. So this activity is to identify whether the following is rational algebraic expression or not. So let's proceed to the number one. So the number one is x squared over x negative 3. So anyone, who is the answer? Who is the answer this equation? This is an a rational expression or not? So if your answer is rational algebraic expression, that is correct. Okay, so let's proceed to the number two. So number two is 1 over x square root of y. So what is the answer of this question? Or what is the answer of this equation? So anyone who can answer this equation, this is a rational algebraic expression or not? Oh, Mr. Ferrero again, your answer is not. So that is correct. This equation is not rational algebraic expression. So why it is not rational algebraic expression? So square root of y, it is an example of irrational numbers cannot be written as a fraction. So therefore, rational expression is a fraction in the form of a over b, where a and b are monomials or polynomials. And for the number 3, as you can see, or obviously, the answer of the number 3 is not rational algebraic expression, as you can see, right? So the 4 and 5 is obviously the answer is rational algebraic expression, because these two equations is an example of a rational algebraic expression. Okay. How to add fraction with the same denominator? So there are 3 steps on how to add fractions. First, make sure that the bottom numbers or the numerators are the same. And the second one, add the top numbers or the numerators and put that answer over the denominator. And the last one, simplify the fraction if possible. So this is an example of the fraction of with the same denominator, 1 over 4 plus 1 over 4. So the first, as you can see, the bottom numbers or the denominators are already the same, right? So, and the second one, the top of numbers put the answer over the denominator. So we are going to add the numerator, 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, and copy the denominators, 4. So the answer is 2 over 4. And simplify the fraction, 2 over 4 is equal to 1 over 2. How about if the denominators is different? So let's try that fraction. So the example of the fraction with different denominators is 1 over 3 plus 1 over 6. So the bottom numbers are different, and we need to make them the same before we can continue, because we can't add them like that fraction because they are not the same denominator. So the number 6 is twice as big as 3. So to make the bottom or the numerators numbers the same, we can multiply the top and bottom, the first fraction, by 2. 1 over 3 times 2 is equal to 2 over 6. So now, the fraction have the same bottom numbers, which is 6. And our question look like 2 over 6 plus 2 over 6. So the denominators now are the same. So we can go to the next steps. So add the top numbers and put them over the same denominator. So 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. So you add the numerators, 2 plus 1 is equal to 3, and copy the denominators, which is 6. So the answer is 3 over 6. And simplify the fractions. So 3 over 6 is equal to 1 over 3. To add the rational algebraic expression, follow the rule in adding fraction, that is to add with different denominators. Find the LCD and simplify the result. Like for example, 3ab plus 6a squared plus a over bc. So we need to find the LCD. So ab is equal to a times b, and a squared is equal to a times a, bc is equal to b times c. So the LCD is on a times b times c is equal to a squared bc. So add 1 over a over 3a plus 1 over 4b. So since the denominators are not the same, we need to find the LCD. Since 3a and 4b have no common factors, the LCD, or LCM rather, is simplify their product, 3a times 4b. So 3a times 4b is equal to 12ab. So that is the LCD of the fractions. So we need to rewrite the fraction using the LCD. So 1 over 3a times 4b over 4b plus 1 over 4b times 3a over 3a. So it is equal to 4b over 4 over 12ab plus 3a over 12ab. So the answer is 7ab over 12ab. So no need to simplify. Now we are going to add rational algebraic expression. So how to solve this problem? So 5 over x plus 7 over 3. So find the common denominator. So 3 times 5 over 3x plus 3 times 7 over 3x. So combine the fraction with common denominator. So 3 times 5 plus 3 times 7 over 3x, and multiply the numbers. So 3 times 5 plus 3 times 7, or 3x times 7 rather, over 3x. So 3 times 5 is 15. So 15 plus 3x minus x times 7 rather, over 3x. So reorder terms, so the constant are not on the left. So 15 plus x times 7 over 3x. So 15 plus 7x is equal to 3x, and 7x plus 15 over 3x. And also, how to solve this problem? 20a over x plus 2, and plus 2 over x negative 2 plus 3 over x squared negative 4. So add the numbers. So 20a over x negative 4 plus 2 over x plus 3 over x squared. So find the common denominator. So x times 20a over x squared plus x squared negative 4 over x squared plus x times 2 over x squared plus 3 over x squared. So combine the fraction with common denominator. So x times 20a plus x squared negative 4 over, or plus x times 2 plus 3 over x squared. So free order terms, so constant are on the left. So 20 times a plus x squared negative 4 plus x times 2 plus 3 over x squared. And also pre-order terms, so constant are on the left. So 20 times a negative 4 x squared plus x times 2 plus 3 over x squared. And free terms, so constant are on the left also. 20xa negative 4x squared plus 2x plus 3 and over x squared. And rearrange terms. So 20xa negative 4x squared plus 2x plus 3 over x squared. So we need this. We need to arrange these terms. So the bigger is negative 4x squared, and the second one is 20xa plus 2x plus 3 over x squared. That's all. Oh, by the way, after eating your dinner, I would like to encourage to everyone to do your assignments. Determine if the followings are correct. Put a check mark if it is correct, and put an X mark if it is wrong. Put your answer before the number and prove it. That's all for today. No more questions, clarifications. Okay, none. Okay, that's all. Good day and God bless everyone. Goodbye.